Well, hello again and welcome to Tricks to the Trades. Don't mind the trucks going by. Today we're working on a house that's probably circa 1920s. And we've got a problem, as you can see, with the stoop. But they've also put this tile on here. And on the other porch, moisture's got in there and cracked the tiles up and it's messed the concrete up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna jack this up, put a post in here temporarily to take this handrail out of here. I'm gonna replace all that handrail, get rid of the wrought iron, put wood mixed with some black spindles. You'll see what that turns out like. But there's that porch. And then we've already taken this handrail out, as you can see. We cut that out, but you can see the damage here. This is kind of bowed up in the middle. But look what the moisture and then everything freezing just cracked that tile up and did a lot of damage. So we gotta run supports to get this rest of this railing out. I'll show you that in a minute here. That's how we're gonna do that. So today we have the Phantom Carpenter working with us, so you won't see much of him. But anyway, right here we cut that out. You see we got our jack. We took off all the fascia that was on there. We carefully cut all the little trim nails and pulled that down, put it in the garage to protect it. And we've got a block up here of about a 2x8, and with our 4x4 post. So now that we've got that out, we'll go ahead and run two 2x4s. We've got a plate up there, as you can see. We'll come on down here and we'll put another plate on the ground, and that'll support that corner. We're gonna do one over there where that piece of wrought iron is and where that one is. And then that way our concrete guy can come here and he can jackhammer all the concrete up and replace it. Here's a little trick. You ever had a screw it's a 3-inch screw, so you can see there that the shaft is smooth. So when you run it in the board all the way, sometimes you go to unscrew it and it doesn't come out. So here's my little trick. I just set it on something solid, whatever it is. Put a little bit of weight, in this case my foot. Boom, screws out. But you can do the same if you had to hold it up against something and push on the board. Works like a charm. So anyway, I took that off of there. As you see, we've got our temporary permanent jack post in here. So we got a plate on the ground, a couple of 2x4s together, and plate at the top. And then we were able to take that guy out. So there we go, got the jack in there. I left myself just enough room here. So I got this plate separate from that one. This way we can take this one with the 2 2x4s and run it down and support as close to this corner as possible. Sorry, the lighting isn't that good. Jacked that up just a little bit. Should have just a little bit of gap there. Put the one screw out. She's gonna come out. Well, this one's a little different than the other ones. We've actually got soffit. So it looks like they actually put the soffit right around it, cut right around it. And probably once we take that off of there, we'll find that it's like the other porch. At least that piece of handrail, it about came right out. A couple of the old fun square-headed bolts were into the wall. And the other side broke right off as soon as I took those ones out. So that was a win. At least something's easy here. Well, look what a fine mess we've got ourselves into. See, I don't know exactly how they designed this originally, but you can see it's all sagging down. But at least we have some support up here for this jack post that seems to be working. And then over here we're gonna put another board here and we'll come down with our jack post on that one, and I think that should take care of things. Like I always say, you just never know what siding covers up, right? It's covers up a lot. Anyhow, gotta show you what the walking good. Show you all that wrought iron. I don't know what this is gonna fetch in scrap, but let me tell you what, this is the real deal stuff here. I mean, that stuff is solid clean through. Even the top rails, they had a piece underneath, so it was a lot thicker than normal, you know. Normally it's like this. Yeah, it's pretty hefty stuff. All right, well, we're gonna put the last jack post in here for the day, and then that will be ready for my concrete guy, and we'll be back on this project whenever he starts busting out some concrete.
Down here to put these down.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. And we're back at that porch job, and when we ran the supports and stuff, got our concrete guy out here working.
You're on YouTube.
It looks like this might be easy. let's hope. Well, that would explain why that is so so loose and it all broke up like that. So far you don't see any of that. What'd you call it?
Slag.
Yeah, the slag is something we couldn't go over. We'd have to tear it all out.
I think they might have just laid it with a hump like that.
Yeah, you never know.
That hump is hanging here in, too.
Yeah, because look, don't look like nothing moved over here on the edges.
No, I know. It looks solid. I doubt they remortared that in or something. They may have touched it, but it's not like, yeah, it's not like it cracked up and heaved over the years.
Yeah.
That whole edge of that concrete there, dude, might come down. It's real loose where the railing was in. Just letting you know.
There's a...
We just don't want to drop
that. Yeah, don't drop that on your tootsies.
I'm going to get the dump truck back over here with the tailgate down, and something can stay up here and just throwing everything right in the truck.
So far we got an easy one. It don't happen very often. It's going to be pretty easy to take this up. Like they did it in layers. Got some kind of concrete down lower, and then they got a little bit fill here that's higher, but that comes right up.
Okay, the whole thing come up. You might have got fortunate on this one.
Our next big fear is what they do over there behind the door. Whether or not there'll be a stoop or something here, or if this was originally a little concrete pad or something, we'll see. Because this whole thing's been added on. Now, they don't even put them together with a hammer. They just do that automatically.
Well, these ones here, they shove them the whole way down where you can't even fit nothing to it.
But like I was saying, the trick on that one is before you put them together, throw several rags at the bottom or something that, like a sponge, anything like that. Now you can stack them and they'll stay tight, but yet you can get them back apart again. So that's our trick for the day. Can he do it? Can he do it? I got faith in you.
You got it?
Got four guys watching, nobody helping them.
Now who's the star of YouTube?
You got it?
Come on, somebody help him.
Hey! Close to a winner. We'll call that success. So you found the bottom.
Yep.
Well, I figured there had to be a row of block in front of that bridge. That'll work. So are you going to put mesh in here?
Yeah. Yep.
Good. Working on getting the color and stamping. So this is going to have kind of like a stone look stamping on it. So it should turn out pretty nice. Well, that came out pretty good.
Yeah.
Oop, got a little bit of the wood there. I had a little rot years ago. Maybe that's why they redid this concrete right here.
Yeah.
That's old rot. Still good shape.
Yeah.
Good fortune couldn't hold out for too long. So this one actually has a decent pad here. It's probably a good solid 4-inch pad, and they just put the tile directly over it and poured this little skirt around it. So this might not be too hard to take off, but it's going to be jackhammer time for this guy.
says, you see who's doing the work, the old guys. And you see these guys are just standing around. I said, nah, I didn't film them doing work. They did work too. They did good. Well, this is going to go on for a while, so I'm not going to bore the viewers with you spending hours, Jackie. Well, let's see what Pat's up to. Taking out the sidewalk, that's what he's up to. I think Mr. Pat's done this before. Probably about as much as I have. Be able to drag it? You gonna be able to drag it out? How's it going?
Good. What'd you say you were on YouTube? I tried to look it up.
Tricks to the trades, all one word.
Oh, tricks. I looked up tricks.
Tricks to the trades, all
he's
one word.
We just killed her. Wow.
Oh man. Hate to be him. No, I don't blame you one bit. Whoa! Need a 45, not a 35. All right, same size as my machine. You're dead.
Yeah.
Killed her flower. You're in trouble.
Also, I don't know. He was out there drinking Miller and.
Uh-oh. That's why he's taking out the trash. He's hiding the goods. There, you got her all tore out. Awesome. How'd this come out up here, Jackhammer that out? I'll bet it was. Looks good, though. Got the pea gravel all there. No, he didn't hurt the block any. That was what, 4 inches sitting on top of that block? There was a little more.
Yeah, it was something like that.
Looks like it might have been a little more if you look against the brick there. Pretty close. Yep. Okay, so you're just gonna do it all one solid pour and just come out flush. Well, you got it spaced out. I was gonna say, I thought we'd be a little overhang. I see now how you did it. Nice.
Yeah,
just ran a 2x4. Ran a 2x4 down there and then make a crown out of
that lip.
That'll be nice and thick out there at the end too. So that's ideal.
7 inches.
Oh, that'll do it. And then you're gonna be able to pour this with the side porch. Or,
yep.
Okay, and then that way you can come back in and do the sidewalk steps and all that.
Yeah, I'm on for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
Wednesday, Thursday for concrete. Okay. So what do you got to do tomorrow? Frame all this in?
Yeah, we're gonna frame this in. We'll frame them steps in this.
Yeah, form steps. Well, I got her just in the time to see you in action.
Yeah.
Looks good. So are these steps just sitting on some block? Yeah. Just sitting on a little paver, 4x or something. I mean,
nothing, but it's in there. I didn't want to tear the steps apart because.
You can't. They're attached?
Yeah, they are attached.
Okay.
Somehow with that brick, because you couldn't get it, you can't see where, and I wasn't going to tear it all apart because it's not.
Oh, he probably put a board right on there and then built out from that board.
He did.
Okay. Were you able to, you think you'd be able to knock these back or cut them off or so you can do a flush with the concrete?
Yeah, I'm going to have, you ain't going to see none of that.
Right. Nice. Got same deal here with the trimmed out edge. So. Didn't have to take all this up.
No, I got it the whole way around the perimeter and through everything and got everything to
be the right depth.
Whatever to avoid is there is no more. So
nice.
Yeah.
Looks good. Well, that was about 45 minutes.
Not bad.
Not bad at all.
Well, what time is it? 7 o'clock?
Well, he said he came at 7.
Yeah.
It's like 7:55 now. So it didn't take you guys 45 minutes. So apparently that went well.
Well, we'll see how this goes.
He had enough shoots, I guess, to get almost all the way in there then, apparently.
Well, he's going to use the concrete.
No, I meant when you did the one over there.
Oh, yeah.
That's good. Well, let's see how this goes. Kind of a necessary tool for you and your trade, huh?
Yeah.
That buggy. It's probably paid for itself. Well, it's getting rid of the excess is easy enough. Gonna be pouring a sidewalk there anyway. So you can't tell by looking at it right now, but there's actually dye in this. So we were talking about two different ways you can run your dye.
when it comes to your concrete. Now this is going to be like a gray color, so whenever concrete dries it's kind of gray anyway, so it's not a really harsh transition from what would have been normally anyhow. So depending on the color is depending on how much dye you need. It's basically a powder. In this case, we bought it from a place that we get all our supplies from, and we put it right in the truck, mixed it right in there. They dropped the bags off right to the cement company. They poured it right in the truck this morning when they made the mix. It takes a little more, but that way you get a complete color from top to bottom. So if anything chips or anything, or when you're stamping this, because we're putting a pattern in it, whenever you stamp it, all your color will be there. You won't have to worry about any place that doesn't have any color. So that makes it really nice. You could actually bring the powder here and throw it in toward the end of your mix, like throw down some of the lower part of the concrete and then add the dye in and just put it toward the top. But then, just like I say, you run the risk, if you're stamping it out, of getting too deep or something happening. So it's just, it's a little more expensive to get the powder and put it in the truck or at the batch plant, but it's just a better way of doing it. All right, well, we gotta let this cure up enough to get to the stage where we can actually stamp it. So we'll be back then. You turn your back for 1 second. A little pumpy jumped right up in there. That's good. We still gotta finish this. Now if he does that later after you run all the pattern, we got a problem. Puppy's gonna get a bath now. Or a spanking.
I throw me a float. Oh, never mind. I'll go get it.
So here's the forms that we use, patterns. Set that on there and tamp it down and get the pattern. That's the release agent. That's the pigments they put in the truck for the color. Constant cleaning tools. There's your release agent. Like with any trade, it takes a lot of tools. Still a little wet. I'm not just going to show, but it does have a pattern in it, and then that'll dry grayish, whatever the color they pick. We're going to let this other pad set up just a little bit more and be able to stamp that one.
Hey, there's that little one. Watch how you pick that up. You can't remember.
I was wondering if you could just put that back down and touch it up if it, you know, doesn't come up right.
That he did.
Yeah, didn't like it, so he set it back down and re-stamped it.
Yeah. It seemed like they couldn't have some kind of like light roller. You could just.
Yeah.
Even if that would make any sense, but.
Well, actually, that was my thought when I first saw these stamps, because yeah. I've seen them up there, and I'm like, you probably just roll those on, and I'm like, no, you tamp them. So, see, you put the release agent over here. So you were spraying, but
you can't smell it.
Oh, I smell it.
It smells like bubble gum.
Yeah, yeah, it smells good actually. I like it.
Do you spray that on the concrete, or do you spray that on the stamp?
Yeah, on the stamps.
Oh, you sprayed some on the concrete.
Yeah, I sprayed some on the concrete too. Stamps on the concrete.
I'm
didn't come out so good, so you had to clean that off and spray it with some of the release agent.
I'm not in practice anymore.
Well, this week I am.
Yeah, I'm getting my level back up.
Pat, it looks so good, thank you.
Spraying the release agent on the mat.
Look like a granite clutch stone?
It does.
Oh, imagine that.
Does. She's happy. I've sent her pictures of what you've done. And she's happy. So. That's right.
Who cares what Jim thinks?
Great. No, don't matter. No. Mama's happy. Everybody's happy. Yeah, he FaceTimed her and she was like, "It looks beautiful." I was like, "Yay!" That good, huh? You know it's bad when you're that actually came out pretty smooth. Well, yeah, but it doesn't always happen. Well, it doesn't always happen to me, but then I'm not the professional either. But I do that, yeah, damp sponge. I wonder if that's the best way. I like doing it that way. So that 2x4 underneath there, later you're going to come back when it's dry and take that off of there, and that'll just crack off whatever excess is hanging over the 2x4, right?
Yep. All right. I think you're talking to me.
Oh, yeah. I know I talk to myself a lot, but no, I was actually talking to you. So that way it'll make like a crown. It'll stick out that inch and a half past the brick. Pat was saying this has got to dry, and then tomorrow when he comes back, he's got to do a little more framing for the sidewalk, and when he does, he'll clean that release agent off. You got to scrub it, get all that off there before you can seal it. So tomorrow, that's his job. Whether you accepted that job or not, it's your job now, buddy. So that'll be pretty much it for here, and so we'll see you when we come back and get this sidewalk all poured, and probably when we start ready to put this porch back together again.